Hey guys, welcome to the Photoshop training channel. Today I have a very interesting tutorial for you guys. It's going to be a little different than everything I've done so far, but I still think that it will teach you a lot and hopefully it will help you increase your workflow. Now, have you guys heard of Photoshop Script Event Manager? If you haven't, it's a pretty useful tool. It helps you create actions or scripts, and it applies those actions or scripts to an event. I will first take you through how I will normally open up an image. Then I will show you how the Script Event Manager can help us to even expedite that process. So usually I just go to File, Open, and select an image. In this case, I'm gonna select an image that we created in our last tutorial, the Young to Old tutorial, where I made myself look about 80 years older than what I really am. If you're interested in the tutorial, you can check it out at photoshoptrainingchannel.com. But anyway, enough of my shameless plug. Once I open the image, I like to go into the View setting, Screen Mode, and set my screen mode to full screen. And that's so I can take advantage of all the real estate I have, and there's no clutter around my image, and I can just work on my image directly. I can use my keyboard to select different tools, and if there's a tool whose keyboard shortcut I don't know, I can just go over to the left and select whatever I need. Same thing on the right, where my layers panel and all these other options. But anyway, that's the long way of doing it, because every time you open up an image, you have to go into View, Screen, and Full Screen Mode. And you're probably thinking, well, what's the big deal about that? It only takes about a second. And you would be right, it does take about a second, but if you're opening up dozens of images, hundreds of images like I am a day, it can become pretty tedious. So what Photoshop has allowed us to do is it gave us a system in which we can apply actions to an event, in this case, opening up an image. So let me show you how that works. Go into your Actions panel. If you don't have your action icon on the right here, you can just go into Window and click on Actions. Then create a new action. And if you've never created an action, I'll quickly show you how they work. So once this new window is open, just give it a name. I'm gonna name mine Full Screen, and then press Record. And what Photoshop does is it records everything that you do. So if I set my foreground to, say, blue, it's going to record that the foreground was set to blue. If I add a new layer, it's going to record that I added a new layer. If I fill that layer with blue, it's going to remember that I filled that layer with blue. I'm going to press the stop button. I'm going to delete this layer. I'm going to click on the name of the action. I'm going to click on play, and it's going to run through all the steps that we just created, and it's going to recreate that same blue layer. So as you can see, it did all the steps and it came back with the blue layer that we created. Now this is really cool, but the problem with that is, and actually let me just delete these steps since I won't be needing them. The problem of actions is that they don't really record a lot of the settings in the view menu. So for example, if I go to screen mode and select full screen, Photoshop doesn't record that. So I'm gonna press escape. And what you can do is you can go into the flyout of the actions panel and you can select Insert Menu Item. You're gonna get this window right here, don't do anything just yet. And then go into View, Screen Mode, Full Screen. Notice that this is now full screen, and then press OK. Now that action was recorded. I'm gonna press the stop icon. I'm gonna click on full screen, and I'm gonna click the play button. And notice that it takes us into the full screen mode. Now this is really cool, but the problem with that is if we open up an image, and go into the actions panel and we hit play, then we're in the screen mode. Well, that's good, but we're still wasting time. Might as well go into view, screen mode, and full screen. But with Photoshop Script Event Manager, we don't have to do all that. We can just go into File, Scripts, Script Event Manager, and in this window here, we can apply a script or an action to a Photoshop event. So we can select any one of these events, or we can create our own. I'm going to choose Open Document. So every time I open up a document, I want to apply an action. And the action that I want to apply is saving the Photoshop Training Channel folder. You might have a different folder. And I'm going to select the full screen option. I'm going to click on Add, and then I'm going to click on Done. So now, every time I open up an image, I automatically get taken into the full screen mode. And that's the beauty of the Script Event Manager. Not only that, maybe I'm working on a project that I know I'm gonna be using the Helium Brush tool. I can click on the Helium Brush tool. Photoshop is gonna remember that. I'm gonna press stop I'm going to select a different tool just so you can see it's not remembering what I had selected. And I'm going to open up a new image. And when I open up this new image, I have the healing brush tool selected. So this is a very useful technique. It could potentially save you a lot of time. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you learned something from it. And I hope you apply it to your projects. If you want to receive more free tutorials, you can check out PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com, or you can subscribe to my YouTube channel, or you can subscribe to my newsletter where I not only remind you about new tutorials, but I provide free content and free tutorials for my subscribers. So I would recommend signing up. Just go to my website, PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com, and type in your email on the top right and click submit. Once again, thank you for watching. I'll be talking to you very soon.